In this part of the video, I'm going to talk about our image-based 3D reconstruction system. This system consists of a camera, a color camera, which is fixed on a tripod and a turntable. We placed the plant on the turntable and let the turntable rotate with regular angular intervals. And at each stop, we take a picture of the plant. Then we remove the blue background color and convert the image to a black and white image. From every N images, we get a point cloud using multi-view 3D reconstruction techniques. This multi-view 3D reconstruction is based on finding the location of the same parts of the object in each image. So we know the camera parameters, and we know how the turntable moved, and we also know the image location of each part. And using this information, we estimate where the part is in the 3D world. So what we do, we back project the points which correspond to the same part of the image to the 3D space, and we use triangulation and bundle adjustment to find this location in 3D. So we obtain point clouds from various viewpoints. Here, each point cloud is reconstructed using N successive images. Then we merge these 3D point clouds into a single point cloud, so we get the 3D model of the entire plant. So here you see the full reconstructed model. The 3D point cloud, and in the right you see a closer view of top leaves. Then we can apply some post-processing to this model, like noise reduction. Then we can cluster local point features. We use local point features and cluster them to detect the leaves. And then we can apply smoothing, and then fit some polynomial surface to individual leaves. Here's another plant on the turntable and the reconstructed 3D point cloud. So as a conclusion, I'd like to mention the challenges in 3D reconstruction of the plants. One problem with the plants is that they have a high level of self-occlusion, which makes it very difficult to capture the entire geometry. And when the architecture of the plant gets more complex, we get more noise in the reconstructed 3D point cloud. Another problem is the diversity of the size and structure of the plants. And the plants also have thin structures such as leaves and petioles, which makes it very difficult to obtain the exact geometry. And the self-similarity present in the plants make it very difficult to establish correspondences in the 2D images. Thank you for listening.